My name is Queenie Shabby. I am a local poet here in Columbia. I'm a member of the Friendly Slam Team, The Unusual Suspects.
Woo. You what? You know?
I am, like Bugsy said, founder of the Writers Block Poetry Show. I'm also one of the co-founders of One Word Columbia, which is an organization that is representing spoken word and poetry in Columbia, South Carolina. We are the voice. We're the voice. Come out and kicking in doors, all that shit.
That's it.
So, I'm also known as the funny poet, because I like to laugh. I like to make people laugh. Where did Bless go? Okay, Bless is okay, he's going to get something to eat. Fuck it, because I was going to say something about this weekend, but you know, whatever. We're going to rock with it. So I'm going to start off with a poem. I also read poems every now and again, you know, because I write them. Yeah. Might as well read them.
Right, why not?
Actually, I think I might have this one memorized. I'm not sure. We're going to rock it out. So this poem is about a true story, okay? This actually happened. I don't know how many other women it happened to, but it happened to me. And I decided, you know, I'm going to do what a poet does. And I'm going to write about this shit. Why not? So this is called True Story, also known as Hair Boost. While in the aisle of the dollar store, I was approached by two men I didn't know. One said hello. The other smiled. I smiled back with a hello as I often do, then the first man spoke. He said, I was wondering if you could help us out with something. My friend and I are having a bet. He says that isn't your natural hair. And I say that it is. Now at the time, my hair was a beautifully pulled back ponytail with a large curly puff at the end. And although I was taken aback a bit, I continued with my composure and said, your friend is correct. Congratulations. And have a good night. The asker looked shocked, surprised that I admitted it, that I didn't roll my eyes and neck and curse him out. I could have. Shit, I love to curse, but I didn't. So since this isn't the first time that I've been approached like this, this poem, for me and women like me, will forever serve as our detailed reply. I wear wigs, weaves, extensions, and pieces anytime I choose. I can, have, and will change hairstyles right in front of you. I have over 50 wigs at least, all different colors, lengths, and styles that I rock proudly. My kids even try to guess which one I will step out of my room with and celebrate loudly. Enough with the rhyme. Yes, I do have my own hair under here. And if I didn't, the outcome would be the same. I love hair and makeup. I watch reality shows just to look at the looks. So when I rock my own style and I look at the looks of the people that I look, I'm like, look, I'll do what the fuck I want. Too many people worry about the opinions of others. Just like what you like over there. And if wigs aren't what you like, you can stay over there. And still quietly to yourself while you stare. And wait for me to care about how a motherfucker feel about my hair. Bitch, where? Where your ass is at when I was struggling with the straightener?
Hey.
Where your ass is at when all my wigs was getting paid for? Where your ass is at when my edges tried to run off? Where your ass is at when I had to take my bun off? Where were you? So spare me with the discontent for my hair preferences. The comments like, I can't be with the woman that don't have her real hair. Or the women that wear hair and makeup have false advertisement and should be condemned for their lace front mistakes. You do realize that such beliefs as this are a double-edged sword, right? Let's take you out of the house in your best, well-calculated, casual ensemble, crisp haircut or freshly twisted locks, dressed to the nines. And when you say hello, your voice drops an octave. Motherfucker, you don't always sound like that. You pay a barber to correct your tape line and visit him faithfully. Your face ain't always razor bump free. You exfoliate, bitch. And that cologne you drench yourself in isn't your natural scent, but we're expected to rise and shine with 14 plus inches in natural length. Motherfucker, do you have 14 plus inches in natural length? But we're expected to step out of a magazine when we step inside your presence. We're supposed to damage and dye our hair because you like red hats this week? For why? Do you know how valuable we be in a heist? How Havana twists can choke out an enemy? Exactly. How many Snickers can be hidden inside of a Megabone when you go to the movies? You're sleeping on it. Yeah. Clearly. If you can't enjoy women that walk in from work, step out of their clothes, unsheathe their breasty bondage, and release their lace fronts for relief the same way that you take off your unstuffed shoes and smelly socks to spread your tortilla wafting toes and ashy cabin ass meat, then you don't deserve to be in the presence of the she that was she before you even got there. Clearly, I and women like me are not the types that you can be with. Which works well for me, because the man that gets to see me with my hair and makeup off every night loves all of this. And if this isn't the answer that you wanted, then I've done my job, because I never said I had to explain myself. I said, this will be my detailed reply.